will show you how to set up the HEINE ML4 LED headlight with the binocular loupes. One of the big advantages of the ML4 is that you can adjust both the headlight as well as the loupes for your perfect personal fit. In this video, we're going to show you how to adjust both the headlight as well as the loupes to obtain the perfect field of view. Start by loosening the main fixation screw. Then align the unit of the individual loupes and light source so that they point parallel to each other in the same direction. The carrier rail of the magnifying glasses must remain horizontal. Don't tighten the screw yet. We will do that later. These two rotary knobs are for adjusting the headband to get a good fit according to your head size. These two screws hold the right and the left loop in place on the loupe carrier rail. They can be adjusted very flexibly. Loosen the locking screws of the loupes. Now, move each loupe to the outermost position. Don't tighten the screws yet. Here, you can set the size of the light spot, from small to its maximum diameter. We set it to the maximum here. With this knob, you can switch on the light and make stepless adjustments of the brightness. Just remember the position of this knob. We're going to switch it on later. Before jumping into the individual fitting, please make sure that you know what working distance your loupes are designed for. You will find this information in millimeters printed on the front of the loupe carrier rail. For instance, this one is set for 420 millimeters. We will need this distance later on to finalize the setup. Now, let's start with the setup. We'll begin by placing the ML4 on our head and using both rotary knobs to adjust the fit. The headband should be placed on the top of your head and rest against your forehead. Move the loupes and headlight on the rail as close as possible to your eyes. As the main fixation screw is still loose, you can move this freely. When doing this, we recommend holding only the housing of the light. Otherwise, the parallel alignment of the loupes and the light from the beginning can be lost. Make sure your eyelashes do not touch the loupes. If you wear glasses, position the loupes as close as possible to the lenses without them touching. To finish the setup, tighten the main fixation screw. Now let's set up the correct illumination for the visual area to ensure that you see sharp details with the loupes. Switch on the light at a low level. The knob is on the right side. Slowly move both loupes on the rail from the outside inwards. Move them until the viewing area through both loupes are overlapping completely and only one clear viewing area is visible. To finish, fix the locking screws of the loupes. To make sure the magnified field of vision is perfectly illuminated, you may slightly adjust the headlight to your individual need and preference. Now, we can check if everything is perfectly adjusted. To do this, hold out your thumb at approximately the working distance of the loupes. The working distance was the millimeter number on the carrier rail that we looked at in the beginning of the video. You should be able to see your thumb clearly and distinctly in the full spot of light. Depending on what you need to do, whether you work standing or sitting, you can always readjust the headlight and the loupes to get the best field of view. This is particularly helpful for longer procedures. Readjusting will help you find the best angle of view to help achieve a comfortable position. This will help avoid straining and bending your neck. With the HEINE binocular loupes, you have the choice of different magnifications, 2.5, 3.5, 4, and 6 times magnification, as well as different working distances. Find all available loupe configurations and specific technical features about the ML4 on our website, heine.com.